everyone. My name's Amanda, and this is another part of This Is Worbla. So today we're going to talk about something really important about the new Worbla product, TranspArt, or TranspArt, depending on how you're going to pronounce it. TranspArt is very different from Worbla's Finest Art, as we discussed in the previous video, link. And if you are looking to use TranspArt, one of the most misleading things about it we discovered really early on is that it really doesn't like to stick to itself. It technically does. I mean, you heat it up, it will stick to itself, that's not a problem. The problem is that it doesn't stay stuck. And the people who made Worbla did actually give us a big info dump about this. Here's the link to that video. And they even emailed me to correct me when I put information on the Worbla website about sticking TranspArt to itself. And the thing is TranspArt does stick to itself, and you can heat TranspArt and shove the two together and get a really nice bond. The problem is you have about 4 degrees, 5 degrees of temperature in which to do that between you will get a good bond and you will turn your TranspArt into goop, which is not super helpful. So I've done a bunch of tests to give you an idea of how you can stick TranspArt to itself, and in addition to that, how you can stick TranspArt to Worbla's Finest Art, because of the heat issue, you really can't just heat and smash the two of them together particularly well. They pretty much will just peel apart, almost always. So with that in mind, starting off with the most recommended glue, which is Krazy Glue, which is also called, I'm just gonna put the text down here once I Google it. But Krazy Glue is a clear, instant adhesive glue. You usually know it because it's the stuff you're told to never use because you'll glue your hand to your face or something along those lines. It, generally speaking, is not used for cosplay a lot because it melts a lot of things. It'll melt styrofoam, it melts paint, it melts a lot of plastics. But it doesn't melt TranspArt because TranspArt is considered stable. So acetone or Krazy Glue or other glues like that don't melt or warp it, which is great. So the nice thing about Krazy Glue is that it leaves a fairly clear adhesion. You can see where the glue was applied, so you can see, I'm gonna have pictures up. So here's a picture of the like swirly glue that I applied, but it does make a very strong, good adhesive. The only thing that I can find, and you just heard it crack, is if I'm, I think this word is torque. So if I am twisting a piece, you can hear it crack. I haven't actually pulled it apart yet. I could, with a lot of force, I could probably pull these pieces apart with twisting. But as far as actual, like, goes, they're not going anywhere. So for a very strong adhesion that is mostly clear for TranspArt to TranspArt, I'm going to recommend Krazy Glue. If you can't use Krazy Glue, you can't get a hold of it, you do have a couple of other options. Hot glue does work. This is a piece I've done with hot glue. It does remain flexible, so I can do this, and it hasn't cracked or separated. It is decently clear. It's a little bit foggier, I find. It clearly has a layer of something between the two plastics that diffracts the light a little differently. And it also makes your pieces a little bit thicker, but it's not bad in any way. I'd definitely be using hot glue as a major thing. I apologize for the noise if you can hear it. Those are my Daegu. I tried to make them stop. Their treats only hold them for so long. So, hot glue does give, again, a very good general, like, pull value. So if you're joining a piece to a piece and you're going to be worrying about laterally pulling or weight, hot glue is not going to be an issue. You can peel hot glue away from TranspArt fairly easily. So you do have to be careful for pieces that are going to have, again, that twisting motion that I was doing with the Krazy Glue. I can't, and this was high temp hot glue, by the way, low temp hot glue, not even talking about. I can do that. I just got up to shut up the Daegu, so I might have to cut this in. But so you can peel apart hot glue surprisingly easily with this sort of motion or pulling motion. So it's good for things being rested on top of other things that are going to have a lateral pull as well, or weight that's going to potentially be going this way, but nothing that's going to be twisting or moving a lot in your pieces, because it's just going to pull away and separate. I do really like hot glue for joining Worbla's Finest Art to TranspArt. I think it is the best adhesion you get for also molding the two together, because hot glue does not warp TranspArt the way it, generally speaking, warps Worbla's Finest Art, even at the high temp, because TranspArt has a higher activation point. It's about 117, 120 degrees Celsius. So the hot glue allows me to make sure that the Finest Art and the TranspArt are completely aligned when I've shaped them, and it also works especially well if I need to leave a bit of a gap, which, you know, I'm gonna photograph this because that's easier for you to see. So if I need to leave a lip or a gap, it gives me a much easier way of doing that without worrying about losing integral strength. And again, I could pull this a lot, it's not going anywhere. It maintains flexibility, which I do like a lot, but again, if I'm gonna be twisting, I can, and I'm not pulling the hot glue away from the Worbla. The Worbla and the hot glue are really well melded together. But I can, with a decent amount of effort, pull the TranspArt away from the hot glue. Actually, for this piece, the hot glue is tearing, which is kind of nice. So, I mean, I would need a lot of effort to separate these. But the hot glue worked really well. Krazy Glue for Worbla and Finest Art, for Finest Art and TranspArt does adhese well if you're dealing with very flat surfaces, especially if you're applying it to the smooth side of the Finest Art, which is known as the glue side. But if you're applying it to the rougher side, I find that you need a lot more glue and it's not always the strongest adhesion, but I do get a very good adhesion this way, and I get a really, because this is two flat pieces, I have almost no peel up when I try to torque and twist it in this degree. The downside of this is because it's such a thin layer, if you are trying to apply Krazy Glue to a curve, that curve has to be exactly flush between both areas completely, or the glue doesn't stick. It misses those areas because it's such a thin application, and it'll pull apart. So again, I'm still gonna use hot glue for things like this, but if I'm just applying a flat piece onto TranspArt or onto Finest Art, then Krazy Glue will definitely work. My third glue of choice for strength and durability is actually going to be contact cement. This is the smelly stuff of doom. It is the most flexible out of the bunch. So if I need something that's going to flex no matter what I do, if I'm joining TranspArt to TranspArt or Finest Art to TranspArt, this stuff is great. Downsides are it smells to high heaven, so you need to make sure you're working in a well-ventilated area. If you're working on a big piece, you have to work outside or with a ventilator or both, because it will kill your brain cells, and I don't know if it's carcinogenic, but it might be. It probably is. And it's a really good idea to keep in mind that contact cement is not clear. So while it leaves some transparency, especially from a distance, you can see that there's that line here, it discolors your plastic, or it is discolored to start off with, so it has a yellowish tone that you're going to have to deal with. But when you're dealing with TranspArt to Finest Art, that doesn't matter because it's an opaque thing going on to a clear thing. So I really do like contact cement. I think it's the best adhesion, especially on like a pull line. It also, the longer you leave it alone, the stronger it's going to get. These pieces were done a little while ago, so they're decently strong now, but I can still peel up the edges if I really need to, but it's takes a lot of effort. So contact cement's a great option for maintained flexibility. Although for this stuff, I would probably still be using hot glue. One of the methods I'd almost forgotten about, so we're just going to interject it in here, is soldering or melting your plastics together with a soldering iron or a hot knife. And I don't really like this particular method for joining pieces too well, because it's very easy to burn your plastic if you're not careful. Never mind that this is the sort of thing where you're now dealing with fumes that you really don't want to be breathing in for long periods of time, but it is an option. And it's especially good if you're trying to make geometric shapes, like squares and cubes and that sort of thing, because you can actually just run a soldering iron alongside the edge to help join those together. There is a great video of this done by Bambi Cosplay, which is now linked here, and she uses it to make a geometric Bambi deer type thing using TranspArt and a soldering iron. So if you're looking for that sort of a join, and if you do need to be able to join sharp or small edges together, it is going to work decently well, but again, it's not going to hold up to a lot of stress because there's just such a small amount of the plastic holding itself together. So always keep in mind when you're dealing with small edges, whether you're gluing them or whether you're melting them together, you're going to run into issues with it not being as strong as you'd like it to be. If you are working to heat TranspArt and stick it to itself, you absolutely can. It is very, very tricky to do, but it's doable. And layers of TranspArt do keep their transparency, although the more you stick it to itself, the more likely it's going to get cloudy and the more air bubbles you're going to get. Air bubbles are really, really easy to get sticking TranspArt to itself and are very, very difficult to remove. Actually, they're pretty much impossible because when you get TranspArt to the temperature you need to poke a needle through it, unlike finest art, it's goopy. So the goopy plastic sticks to the needle and then sticks to it, and when you pull the needle out, it just closes the hole. So the air still stays there. You've just put a hole through your plastic and then removed the hole completely. It's frustrating. So if you are sticking TranspArt to itself, you have to go really slow. You need an infrared thermometer, and we'll talk about that a lot more in another video, but to give you an idea of how it works, you can actually see here as we're going. What I did was we had three people to heat this sheet. So it's a matter of one person holding the TranspArt perpendicular to the piece that it's going to be attached to, that TranspArt being heated with the infrared thermometer telling us when we got to about 120 degrees, we were sitting between 117 and 125, making sure we are pointing the gun right at that 90 degree angle where the pieces would theoretically meet, and once both pieces were heated, very, very slowly lowering the TranspArt down and then rolling over it to get it smooshed together. Even then, we got air bubbles. It was very difficult to do, and I can still peel apart some of those pieces. In fact, this piece, which is small, but I did just for this video right now, you can see it's cloudy. If we heat it up again, we might get some of that transparency back. Worbla does, TranspArt does regain some clarity if it's a little cloudy and you heat it up again. But even this piece that is now very flexed and very stuck together and isn't going to peel up from regular pulling like this, if I pull too much from the corner, I've actually already started to separate it. And I can, with not too much effort. And if you watched my previous video, you watched me do this with my sword, just pull the layers apart. So realistically, unless you have a incredibly good reason that I haven't actually come up with yet to not use any sort of glue and to try to stick TranspArt to itself, you're gonna use glue. So yeah, that's your breakdown for glue so far. There are other glues out there. I don't know about them yet. There are a whole bunch I still have to try, but for the moment, these are the ones I'd recommend. Realistically, it's going to be hot glue or Krazy Glue for most of what you're doing, and maybe rubber cement for things that you need a lot of flex on. Always, always, always test your glues before you start working on them. Always read the instructions. If your glue, if your Krazy Glue of any variety, requires water to work, don't use it because it will create bubbles again when you're sticking your TranspArt to itself, and that's annoying. And always, if you are planning to paint the inside or the underside of your TranspArt, always test your paint against your glue. One of the things that I found out was that Krazy Glue and acrylic paint do not get along very well. So I stuck my pieces together and I just ended up having the paint peel away from my TranspArt because the Krazy Glue ate through it. So always test your paint and your glue before you do your final project. If you've got any questions, don't hesitate to ask. I'm glad you guys tuned in, and there'll be more videos coming up soon. Until then, this, no wait, This is Worbla.